Welcome back. Well, we are now about 25 days or even less for the budget to be announced. Separately, of course, the Reserve Bank has struck a cautious note and hinted at stress for the financial sector. They will probably come with something different when the financial stress next stress report comes. But we are hearing of MSME and retail asset sales to asset reconstruction companies. So really, there are many things to ask a man who knows all these answers. We have with us Mr. Rasi Shah, the CEO, head of Edelweiss Group. Good morning, Rasish. Thank you very much indeed for joining us. Well, first up, the budget. I mean, a very important one, as the finance minister has been stressing, coming after a momentous 2020. What, from the financial sector point of view, would be the top requirement or ask?
I think the most important one is the stimulus, I would say, because I think it's an important budget. But, you know, given what has happened with COVID last year, people are not going to really worry about whether the fiscal deficit for this year, FY21, is, you know, 8 or 9 or 10, because I think that most of that is expected to be, you know, fairly high because of COVID. So I think COVID will allow a lot of the past to be, you know, accepted by the markets very easily, by the investors very easily. I think going forward, the economy has started doing well. It needs momentum, and I think concerted action by RBI and the government will be very important. What the government can do is spend money, because I think RBI has done whatever it has done. You know, liquidity, interest rates low. As you know, liquidity is at an all-time high. Interest rates are, home loans are at an all-time low. All that has happened. But that still benefits only 20% of the economy. There is another 80% of the economy which is not direct beneficiary of the monetary policies. For that, the fiscal policies are very important. And for that, I think stimulus, cutting tax rates for common man is going to be a very important one. I don't think there is anything specific for capital markets that is required, because I think capital markets, as you can see, are doing well on their own. So as long as there is nothing untoward towards capital market, nothing proactively extra is required. But I think stimulus for us will be the biggest one, especially for the middle class, for the lower middle class, for the rural population. And that will give the momentum to the economy in the next year. Over and above that, I think privatization is a big theme now. Government has already made a lot of movement on that. We expect to see a lot of opening up on that. A lot of action on that. We expect to see a lot of opening up on FDI, especially insurance and others, because we need equity money. For the next year, if the economy has to grow, we need to arrange capital, equity capital, credit capital. And for equity capital, opening up FDI is also going to be important. So I think these are the 3-4 areas which will be very important. A lot of people are talking about bank recap and all. I don't think that's a big item on the agenda, because banks are doing well. Even PSU banks are doing well. And most analysts are upgrading earnings. So I think banks will now take care of themselves, though there could be some COVID-related stress. I think it's not going to be very heavy. So I think I wouldn't look at government spending a lot on bank recapitalization, but I would look at raising money through privatization, very aggressive privatization, opening up FDI.
That part we got. I mean, those they've already announced, divestment and PLI. I was only wanting to know if there's anything way out. You said, okay, more FDI to be allowed in insurance. That, according to you, would be the big ask. Well, let me come to the...
If you see, you know, in banking, you're allowing up to 75%. So why insurance should be kept at 51? So insurance should also go up to 75. And insurance needs capital. And if you look at the long-term needs of the economy, the banking sector cannot provide long-term credit. The insurance sector can. So if the insurance sector can grow faster, then we can get a lot of India savings channelized through the insurance sector into long-term infrastructure and other projects. So for that, insurance needs to grow faster. So I think
I'm trying to rush you, because we have lots of questions for you. I got your point on insurance, though I'm not very sure if any of them are still strapped for capital in the insurance sector. But let me come to you yourself. What is Edelweiss's capital position? You all just raised NCDs. So if you can give us an idea of what is your capital adequacy and what is likely to be the amount you have to set aside for credit costs.
In fact, ironically, in all our entities, currently capital adequacy is at an all-time high. Like our NBFC is at 24% capital adequacy. Our HFC, Housing Finance Company, is at 28%. ARC is at 35%. As you know, the requirement is only 15%. So we are almost, we used to be at about 18-20% capital adequacy in normal times. So equity capital, because capital adequacy is about equity. When you say capital, we sometimes mean equity, sometimes we talk about liquidity. So let me address equity capital first. I think equity capital for most of the banks and NBFCs is now fairly in place. Maybe some PSU banks require equity, but otherwise, I think for us, in almost every entity which is credit related, our capital adequacy is an all-time high. On liquidity also, we are actually currently at almost 23-24% of our total borrowings is liquidity on hand. In fact, it's now become very strange because that liquidity is hurting you because interest rates are coming down. So your yield on those, that excess liquidity is also coming down. We are seeing growth coming back. So housing finance has started growing fairly well. We expect from this quarter, MSME loans also to start coming back. We are seeing a fair amount of little bit of movement on that also. So I think growth on housing and MSME will come back. But liquidity-wise, we have almost about 7,500 crores of liquidity on a total borrowing of only about 28,000 crores. So I think there is a lot of liquidity. And we recently raised the NCD issue of, we were planning 200 crores, 100 plus 100, and in 5 days we got 240 crore. It was oversubscribed, overwhelmingly. So I think the bond market is also coming back. The good news is that the banks were always, providing credit to the NBFCs in the last 2 years, but the bond markets had shut down for various reasons, as you know. I think the bond markets are opening up again and opening up for NBFCs, and that is good news because that will drive some amount of credit growth again.
So it's good to hear that you have 7,500 crores of liquidity on the books as of now. Rasesh, good morning. Happy New Year to you. The RBI, though, put out a report where they were quite cautious on the banking sector as a whole and expect more pressure in terms of asset quality. Do you think the worst of the stress in the banking and the NBFC sector is not behind us just yet? And where do you still see some vulnerable pockets now?
So I think it's an interesting one. What RBI is saying is not wrong because I think there is going to be impairment, there is going to be extra credit cost. So if you look at most NBFCs and banks operate at about 1.5% kind of credit cost on an average. I think for the next 2 years, because of COVID, this will go up by another 1%. So I think 1 plus 1, 2% extra credit cost is going to be required. So RBI is not wrong because that's not a small number because that will have to go through the P&Ls of banks. I think most banks have started providing for it and they've raised equity against it. If you look at most of the banks have raised equity, which is in the range of 2-4% of the total assets. So I think banks have covered that through capital raising, equity raising, and they've covered it via providing and all that. So I think if things remain the way they are and improve as they are improving, the economy is really on a comeback. And I think after a long time, even a lot of diehard skeptics on Indian economy are starting to become positive on the economy over the next 4-5 years point of view. So on a 4-5 year horizon, if economy is coming back, then this whole NPA thing of the last 5-6 years, which has really plagued the Indian banking sector, should start getting over. So I think we will see some impairments, increase in impairment. Most likely, what is about 1-1.5 will become 2.5-3 as percentage of the assets as credit cost. But I think it's in the price, it's expected, and it is already provided for via equity raising and via this. So I don't think there is going to be a crisis or what I call unpleasant surprises. I think what happens is we all react very badly to unpleasant surprises and the unexpected. I think this is more or less getting expected, so it won't create a lot of problem.
Well, we are running out of time, Rasesh. So very quickly, banks have now started putting retail assets on the block, a fairly large number of them. Ritu Singh reported that yesterday. Do you think there will be enough buyers, and do you think this is the way forward? How are you looking at this development?
Absolutely. I think if you look at the ARC industry, I think 2014 onwards, The ARC industry grew by buying assets, wholesale assets from the banks, because that was a need of the hour. And the banks needed somebody to take over and resolve that those wholesale assets. And we saw big growth in the ARC industry from 2014 onwards under the 1585 structure. I think the same is happening for retail and MSME. Our own ARC has seen a lot of inquiries, and we have been actually last 2 years, most assets we have bought are in retail and SME sector only, not in the wholesale arena. So I think this is now going to be the need, because of COVID related, as I said, there is going to be impairment, there is going to be stressed accounts. It's been provided for, so it's not going to be unpleasant surprise, but somebody will still have to resolve them. So especially even things like mortgages and
security. What do you think? There will be enough buyers for the retail assets?
I think so. I think there is a demand for about 1 lakh crore a year of retail assets to be sold.
Okay.
So if you look at that, even half of that gets sold, that's about 50,000 crores, and they usually will get sold at about 50 cents to a dollar. So 25,000 crore on 85.15. So ARCs or the buyers have to provide 15%, which is about 3-4,000 crore. I think that kind of capital is available. So I would expect in the coming year about 40-50,000 crores worth of retail assets to get sold by the banks to ARCs. And ultimately, ARCs are good at recovery, resolution, and they provide capital also because they put in their skin in the game. So I think what was wholesale for the last 5-6 years will be retail for the next 3-4 years.
Okay. And I don't know if all the bankers are going to be happy with that 50 cents to the rupee, but nevertheless, one hopes the sales happen. Of your verticals, I just wanted two quick questions. In your corporate credit and retail, what kind of credit cost are you expecting in the current year and next? And in your wealth management, what kind of growth can you see in the current year itself? It seems to be the golden year for wealth management.
Absolutely. I think on the wholesale, credit cost usually have averaged about 2.5 to 3% a year in normal times. Last 3-4 years, they've exceeded 5%. So that has gone up. I think it will remain about 2.5 to 3%. But most of the excess provisioning or most of the extra impairment that has to be taken has been taken. As you know, about 2 quarters ago, we took a big impairment and tried to accelerate the provisioning, try to accelerate the impairment. And the good news about NBFCs is because we don't operate in NPA anymore, NPA structure anymore. We operate on impairment structure under the new Ind AS guidelines. So the mark to market is a lot faster. So the loans which are stressed get marked down a lot faster in the new Ind AS rather than under the NPA structure. So I think that is a good news. In the last 2 years, a lot of impairment has been taken. Going forward, I would expect corporate to still have about 2-3% credit cost. I think retail should be between about 1-1.5%. Of course, unsecured will be higher. Home loans will be lower. But if you take the average of that, I think that is what we should expect going forward. And that is now in the price. On the wealth management side, we're seeing a huge, I think that whole story about financialization of household savings, which has been there, is really also coming of age. And we are seeing that because interest rates are low, people are looking for yield, people are looking for investments, people are also doing more long-term planning. And that is where wealth management comes in. So amongst the household financial assets, only 10% is advised by the wealth managers. Currently, 90% of the household financial assets are not advised by anybody. So household financial assets are growing at 13-14% a year. Mm-hmm. But even the 10% which are advised should go to 20% as our economy develops and the sophisticated products. And we are, Lata, one of the most interesting things that is happening is earlier wealth management was all about equity. But now we have started seeing credit products, like as InvITs and REITs and all this have started coming about. A lot of the investors, high net worth investors, also want yield products. They want, but not the bank yield of 3-5%. They want 10% kind of yield. And that is going to be one of the big developments of the wealth management industry.
All right. We'll have to leave it at that. Out of time, Rasesh, thank you very much for joining us. Have a great 2021.
Thank you. Happy New Year to all of you. Bye.
Thank you. Okay, we'll just run the Edelweiss financials past you. The consolidated total income will come, followed by the consolidated profit after tax. Okay, of course, 21 will be a difficult year. We'll take a break on that note, but up next, a lot of positives for the defense sector. We're going to take stock of the outlook for 2021 with Siddharth Mishra, Chairman and Managing Director, Bharat Dynamics.